God save violence and heroes. God save violence and the all. Whether on a scaffold high or a battlefield we die, or what matter when for Erin dear we fall. High upon the gallows tree swung the noble hearted tree, by the thankful tyrant stricken in their bloom. But they met him face to face with the courage of their race, and they went with souls undaunted to their doom. God save Ireland, said heroes. God save Ireland, said the all. Whether on a scaffold high or a battlefield we die, oh, what matter when for Erin dear we fall. Climbing up the rugged stairs rang their voices out in prayer, with England's fatal cord around the cast. Close behind a gallows tree, kissed like brothers lovingly, true to hope and faith and freedom to the last. God save Ireland, said the heroes. God save Ireland, said the all. Whether on a scaffold high or a battlefield we die, oh, what matter when for Erin dear we fall. Never till the latest day shall my memory pass away of our gallant lives thus given for our land. On the cause must go, whether gyre or woe, till we make this land a nation free and grand. God save Ireland, said the heroes. God save Ireland, said the all. Whether on a scaffold high or a battlefield we die, oh, what matter when for Erin here we fall. God save Ireland, said the heroes. God save Ireland, said the all. Whether on a scaffold high or a battlefield we die, oh, what matter when for Erin here we fall. Come tell me, Sean O'Farrell, tell me why you hurry so. Hush, my buckle, hush, I'm listening, and his cheeks were all aglow. I bear orders from the captain, get you ready quick and soon, for the pikes must be together at the rising of the moon. At the rising of the moon, at the rising of the moon, for the pikes must be together at the rising of the moon. Oh, then tell me, Sean O'Farrell, where the gathering is to be. In an old spot by the river, right well known to you and me. One more word, a single token, whistle up the marching tune, with your pike upon your shoulder, at the rising of the moon. At the rising of the moon, at the rising of the moon, with your pike upon your shoulder, at the rising of the moon. Out of many a mud-walled cabin, eyes were watching through the night. Many a manly heart was throbbing for the blessed morning light. Murmurs passed along the valley like a banshee's lonely croon, and a thousand blades were flashing at the rising of the moon. At the rising of the moon, at the rising of the moon, and a thousand blades were flashing at the rising of the moon. All along that singing river, a dark mass of men were seen. High above their shining weapons hung their own beloved green. Death to every foe and traitor, forward strike a marching tune. And our army buys for freedom, it's the rising of the moon. It's the rising of the moon, it's the rising of the moon. And our army buys for freedom, it's the rising of the moon. Well, they fought for dear old Ireland, and full bitter was their fate. What glorious pride and sorrow fills the name of 98. And yet, while hearts are beating in a manhood's burning croon, we will follow in their footsteps at the rising of the moon. At the rising of the moon, at the rising of the moon, we will follow in footsteps at the rising of the moon. At the rising of the moon, at the rising of the moon, we will fields by day. Till a sudden thought came to my mind that I should roam my way. I've always hated slavery since the day that I was born. Now I'm off to GI in the IRA, and I'm off tomorrow morn. So we're all off to Dublin, in the green, while the helmets they glisten in the sun. Where the bayonets flash and the rifles crash to the echo of a Thompson gun. I leave behind my pick and spade, I leave behind my plough, and I leave behind my old grey mare, no more I'll need her now. I leave behind my Mary, she's the girl I do adore, and I wonder if she thinks of me when she hears the cannons roar. So we're all off to Dublin, in the green, while the helmets they glisten in the sun. Where the bayonets flash and the rifles crash to the echo of a Thompson gun. But when the war is over and dear old Ireland's free, I'll take her to the church to wed, and a rebel's wife she'll be. For some men fight for silver, and some men fight for gold, but the IRA are fighting for the land that the Saxons stole. So we're all off to Dublin, in the green, while the helmets they glisten in the sun. Where the bayonets flash and the rifles crash to the echo of a Thompson gun. So we're all off to Dublin, in the green, while the helmets still glisten in the sun. Where the bayonets flash and the rifles crash to the echo of a Thompson gun. Are filled with sorrow and with sadness. Many hearts are filled with anguish and with pain. For old Ireland now she hangs her head in mourning. For those men who died at Upton for Sinn Féin. Let the moon shine out tonight along the valley, where those men who fought for freedom now are laid. May they rest in peace, those men who died for Ireland, in the lonely woods at Upton for Sinn Féin. Some are thinking of their mothers, wives and sweethearts. Some are thinking of their dear old Irish homes. Did they think that when they drove along the valley, when they marched out from Cork City to their doom? Let the moon shine out tonight along the valley, where those men who fought for freedom now are laid. May they rest in peace, those men who died for Ireland, in the lonely woods at Upton for Sinn Féin. Then the morning cry rang out, fix your bayonets. And quite gallantly they fixed them for the fray. Gallantly they fought and died for dear old Ireland, in the lonely woods at Upton far away. Let the moon shine out tonight along the valley, where those men who fought for freedom now are laid. May they rest in peace, those men who died for Ireland, in the lonely woods at Upton for Sinn Féin. In the lonely woods at Upton for Sinn Féin. A great crowd had gathered outside of Kilmainham, with their heads all uncovered. They knelt on the ground, for inside that grim prison lay a brave Irish soldier, his life for his country about to lay down. Well, he went to his death like a true son of Ireland, and the firing party he bravely did face, when the order rang out to present Arnhem's fire. James Connolly fell into a ready-made grave. While the black flag was hoisted, the cruel deed was over. Gone was the man who loved Ireland so well. There was many a sad heart in Ireland that morning, when they murdered James Connolly, the Irish rebel. God's curse on you, England, you cruel-hearted tyrant. Your deeds, they would shame all the devils in hell. There are no flowers blooming, but the shamrock is growing on the grave of James Connolly, the Irish rebel. Many years have gone by since the Irish rebellion, when the guns of Britannia they loudly did speak, and the bold IRA they stood shoulder to shoulder, as the blood from their bodies flowed down Sackville Street. While the forecourts in Dublin the British bombarded, and the spirit for freedom they tried hard to quell. But above all that din came the cry, no surrender. It was the voice of James Connolly, the Irish rebel. Give me the Irish Republican Army, give me the green, white and gold every time. Give me the tree-leaf shamrock of Ireland, the land I hope will soon be mine. Send the soldiers back to where they came from. Give us our country back once again. Give us the Irish Republic and army to make our land a nation once again. Side by side, our heroes died to answer Ireland's noble call. Down to the ears, blood, sweat and tears, they fought from Cork to Donegal. Now they're gone, we struggle on to make our country free. We can't give in, for we must win, for the land of peace and liberty. Give me the Irish Republic and army. Give me the green, white and gold every time. Give me the tree-leaf shamrock of Ireland. The land I hope will soon be mine. Send the soldiers back to where they came from. Give us our country back once again. Give us the Irish Republic and army to make our land a nation once again. James Connolly, Bobby Sands, Pierce and the Great Wolf Tone, Joe MacDonald, Robert Emmett and Sean South from Garry Own, Armagh and Derry, Belfast City, they struggle to be free. So Irish men, unite again for the land of peace and liberty. Give me the Irish Republic and army. Give me the green, white and gold every time. Give me the three-leaf shamrock of Ireland. The land I hope will soon be mine. Send the soldiers back to where they came from. Give us our country back once again. Give us the Irish Republic and army to make our land a nation once again. Give me the Irish Republic and army. Give me the green, white and gold every time. Give me the three-leaf shamrock of Ireland. The land I hope will soon be mine. Send the soldiers back to where they came from. Give us our country back once again. Give us the Irish Republic and army to make our land a nation once again. There's a uniform that's hanging in what's known as Father's room. A uniform so simple in its style. It has no braid of gold or silk, no hat with feathered plume. Yet me mother had preserved it all the while. One day she made me try it on, a wish of mine for years. In memory of your father, Sean, she said. As I put the sambron on, she was smiling through her tears as she placed the broad black brimmer on me head. It's just a broad black brimmer with ribbons frayed and torn by the careless whisk of many a mountain breeze. An old trench coat that's all battle-stained and worn, and breeches almost threadbare at the knees. A Sam Brown belt with a buckle big and strong, a holster that's been empty many a day.
But not for long.
When men claim Ireland's freedom, the ones who choose to lead them will wear the broad black brimmer of the IRA. This uniform's been worn by me father long ago, as he reached me mother's homestead on the run. This uniform's been worn in that little church below, as our father Mac, he blessed him there as one. After truce and treaty at the parting of the way, he wore it when he marched out with the rest.
And the best,
as they bore his body down that rugged heather gray, they placed a broad black brimmer on his chest. It's just a broad black brimmer with ribbons frayed and torn by the careless whisk of many a mountain breeze. An old trench coat that's all battle-stained and worn, and breeches almost threadbare at the knees. A Sam Brown belt with a buckle big and strong, and a holster that's been empty many a day.
But not for long.
When men claim Ireland's freedom, the ones you choose to lead them will wear the broad black brimmer of the IRA.
they say that the lakes of Killarney are fair. No stream like the Liffey could ever compare. If it's water you want, you'll find nothing more rare than the stuff that's made down by the ocean. The sea, oh, the sea is Grachial McCree. Long may it roll between England and me. It's a sure guarantee that somehow we'll be free. Oh, thank God we're surrounded by water. Tom Moore made his waters meet fame and renown. A great lover of anything dressed in a gown. In brandy, the bandy old Saxon he drowned, and he threw ne'er a drop in the ocean. The sea, oh, the sea is Grachial McCree. Long may it roll between England and me. It's a sure guarantee that somehow we'll be free. Thank God we're surrounded by water. Now the Scots have their whiskey, the Welsh have their leek, and their poets are paid about 10 pence a week. Provided no hard words on England they speak. Oh Lord, what a price for devotion. Now the Danes came to Ireland with nothing to do but dream of the plunder old Irish they slew. Well, you will, in your Viking, said Brian Boru, and he threw them back into the ocean. Two foreign old monarchs in battle the giant, each wanting his head on the back of Cain. If the Irish had sense, they don't vote in the bind and partition throw into the ocean. The sea, oh the sea is Grachial McCree. Long may it roll between England and me. It's a sure guarantee that somehow we'll be free. Thank God we're surrounded by water. I'll sing you a song of a terrible wrong when the flags all flew at half mast. A man, he lay dead, he'd been riddled with lead, and he died on the streets of Belfast. The radio said, there's another shot dead. He died with a gun in his hand. But they never said why Billy Reid had to die, for he died to free Ireland. Now it happened one day when the bold IRA went out to fight for their land. With an old Thompson gun, put the troops on the run, and return to their home was the plan. The radio said, there's another shot dead. He died with a gun in his hand. But they never said why Billy Reid had to die, for he died to free Ireland. While returning the gun, Billy met British guns. When the fight had begun, his position was dire when his gun wouldn't fire. So he died with an old Thompson gun. And the radio said, there's another shot dead. He died with a gun in his hand. But they never said why Billy Reid had to die, for he died to free Ireland. Although he lay dead, he was kicked in the head. By the hair they dragged him around. But they'll still fear him yet, they can never forget how brave Billy Reid stood his ground. And the radio said, there's another shot dead. He died with a gun in his hand. But they never said why Billy Reid had to die, for he died to free Ireland. If you think he was right, come and join in the fight and help to free Belfast. For the blood that he shed, although he lies dead, in our hearts his memory will last. And the radio said, there's another shot dead, and he died with a gun in his hand. But they never said why Billy Reid had to die, for he died to free Ireland.
And the radio said that there's another shot dead, and he died with a gun in his hand. But they never said why Billy Reid had to die, or he died to free Ireland. Oh, Father, why are you so sad on this bright Easter morn, when Irish men are proud and glad of a land where they were born? Oh son, I see in memory's view of a far-off distant day, when being just a lad like you, I joined the IRA. Where are the lads who stood with me when history was made? Oh, Cromachree, I long to see the boys of the old brigade. From hills and farms, the call to arms was heard by one and all. From the glen came brave young men to answer Ireland's call. It was long ago we faced a foe, the old brigade and me. And by my side they fought and died that Ireland might be free. Where are the lads who stood with me when history was made? Oh, Cromachree, I long to see the boys of the old brigade. Now, my boy, I've told you why on Easter morn I sigh. For I recall my comrades all in those dark, long days gone by. I think of men who fought in glen with rifle and grenade. May heaven keep those men who sleep from the ranks of the old brigade. Where are the lads who stood with me when history was made? Oh, Cromachree, I long to see the boys of the old brigade. Struggle is over and the boys are defeated. Old Ireland surrounded with sadness and gloom. We were defeated and shamefully treated, and I, Robert Emmett, awaiting my doom. Hung, drawn and quartered, sure that was my sentence. Soon I will show them no coward am I. My crime is a love of a land I was born in, a hero I've lived and a hero I'll die. A barge lay at anchor waiting to take me over the billows to the land of the free. But I must see my sweetheart, for I know she'll cheer me, and with her I will sail far over the sea. But I was arrested and cast into prison. Tried as a traitor, a rebel, a spy, but no one can call me a knave or a coward. For a hero I've lived, and a hero I'll die. So hark the bells tolling, I well know its meaning. My poor heart tells me it is my death knell. In come the clergy, the warden is leading, and I have no friends here to bid me farewell. So goodbye to old Ireland, my parents and sweetheart, companions in arms, to forget you must try. I am proud of the honor, it was only my duty. For a hero I've lived, and a hero I'll die. Bold Robert Emmet, the darling of Erin, bold Robert Emmet, he'll die with a smile. Farewell companions, both loyal and daring, I lay down my life for the Emerald Isle. Was one morning in July, I was walking to Tipperary, when I heard a battle cry from the mountains overhead. As I looked up in the sky, saw an Irish soldier laddie. He looked at me right fearlessly and said, "Will you stand in the band like a true Irish man and go and fight the forces of the crown? Will you march with O'Neill to an Irish battlefield? For tonight we're going to flee old Wexford town." Said I to that soldier boy, "Won't you take me to your captain? It would be my pride and joy for to march with you today." My young brother fell at Cork, and my son had an escorty, and to the noble captain I did say, "Will you stand in the band like a true Irish man and go and fight the forces of the crown? Will you march with O'Neill to an Irish battlefield? For tonight we're going to flee old Wexford town." As we march back again in the shadow of the evening, with our banners flying low to the memory of our dead, we return unto our homes, but without our soldier laddie. Yet I never will forget these words he said, "Will you stand in the band like a true Irish man and go and fight the forces of the crown? Will you march with O'Neill to an Irish battlefield? For tonight we're going to free old Wexford town. Will you stand in the band like a true Irish man and go and fight the forces of the crown? Will you march with O'Neill to an Irish battlefield? For tonight we're going to Feo Wexford town. For tonight we're going to Feo Wexford town." All you young rebels, and list while I sing. For the love of one's country, it's a terrible thing. It banishes fear with the speed of a flame, and it makes us all part of patriot game. My name is O'Hanlon, I've just turned 16. My home is in Monaghan, that's where I was weaned. I learned all my life cruel England's to blame. So now I'm a part of the patriot game. It's nearly 2 years since I've wandered away with a local battalion of the bold IRA. I read of our heroes and I wanted the same. So now I'm a part of the patriot game. This island of ours has for long been half free. 6 counties lie under John Bull's tyranny. And some of our leaders were greatly to blame for shirking their part in the patriot game. Now they told me how Connolly was shot in his chair, his wounds from the battle all bleeding and bare, his fine body twisted, all battered and lame, for playing his part in the patriot game. Now as I lie here with my body all holes, I think of those traitors who bargained and sold. I wish that my rifle had not done the same to those quislings who sold out the patriot game. To those quislings who sold out the patriot game.
South from Galleon, another mark
before old Ireland shone south from Galleon.
Born in a Dublin street where the Ryle drums had beat, and the laughing English feet, they tramped all over us. Each and every night, when me father come home tight, he'd invite the neighbours outside with his chorus. Come out your blackened tans, come out and fight me like a man. Show your wives how you won medals down in Flanders. Tell them how the IRA made you run like hell away from the green and lovely lanes in Kilishandra. Come let me hear you tell how you slandered great Parnell, when you taught him well and truly persecuted. Where are the sneers and jeers that you bravely let us hear when our heroes of 16 were executed? Come tell us how you slew them poor Arabs 2 by 2, like the Zulus, they had spears and bow and arrow. How you bravely slew each one with your 16-pound gun, and you frightened emperor natives to the marrows. Come out your blackened tans, come out and fight me like a man. Show your wives how you won medals down in Flanders. Tell them how the IRA made you run like hell away from the green and lovely lanes in Kilishandra. The day is coming fast, and the time is here at last, when each yeoman will be cast aside before us. And if there be a need, sure my kids will sing Godspeed with a verse or two of Stephen Bean's chorus. Come out your blackened tans, come out and fight me like a man. Show your wives how you won medals down in Flanders. Tell them how the IRA made you run like hell away from the green and lovely lanes in Kilishandra. Come out your blackened tans, come out and fight me like a man. Show your wives how you won medals down in Flanders. Tell them how the IRA made you run like hell away from the green and lovely lanes in Kilishandra.
Once again, a nation once again.